हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वंस अगेन वेलकम बैक टू मिजो स्टडी वीडियो क्लासेस। एंड एज इट इज क्लियर, टुडे वी नीड नॉट टू डिस्कस व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट इन टुडेज वीडियो। एज इट्स मेंशन इन दिस पर्टिकुलर फर्स्ट स्लाइड, दैट इज सीबीएसई पैटर्न क्वेश्चन एक्सरसाइज एंड द टॉपिक ऑफ ब्रांच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, दैट इज थर्मोडायनामिक्स। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट दिस डिस्कशन ऑफ सम क्वेश्चंस बेस्ड अपॉन द सीबीएसई पैटर्न फॉर thermodynamics. Once again the methodology is going to be same question, then I will not only tell you the answer but also how you can write down the answer in proper manners. Fine. So here comes your first question, and as usual I would like to first mark this thing, that is first read the instructions carefully. It is for 1 mark, and that too question number 1 and 2 both. Now sometimes you may notice that the question for 1 mark is not very short question. It is just because of the reason, sometimes basically it is the choice of the paper setting faculty who is setting your question paper. So you can't simply say, sir, it is for 1 mark and you are asking like this. So that's why I am also putting some long questions. It is for 1 mark, but at least you have to write down as per the requirement of the questions. If the long question they asked, you should try to answer it properly. Fine, you can't argue. So as per the need of the question, your answer should be according to like that flexible approach. So here, does the internal energy of an ideal gas change in an isothermal process? Actually these were 2 questions. One is, does the internal energy of an ideal gas change in an adiabatic process? So it was like 2 questions. So what I thought, just combine them, fine, so that in just 1 question you can learn the material for at least 2 questions. A time saving approach. So first is internal energy of ideal gas. Fine, so let me allow to explain it. Actually you have to simply write down yes or no. Say for example, does the internal energy of ideal gas change in an isothermal process? Isothermal process means temperature remains constant, so no change. But I will write down sentences so that you can get the much better understanding. In examination you need not to mention that. Fine. First line I am writing, which is a general line, that is, for ideal gas internal energy is function of temperature. Okay, it means if temperature is not changing, so dT is equal to 0, and if dT is equal to 0, then so du is equal to 0. So answer is no change. Now in your answer sheet you need not to write down this much, you have to simply mention no change. It is for your understanding. Fine. Then comes adiabatic process. Now students, this is another question possible. Fine. So I thought there is no point of putting 2 questions onto different slides, that's why I placed this. So adiabatic process means what? Adiabatic process, dq is equal to 0, and what is the first law? Dq is equal to du plus dw. Fine. So for adiabatic process, internal energy minus dW. Fine. It means simply for adiabatic process, internal energy of ideal gas is not 0. Fine. So this is the method with the help of which you can write down the answers for these type of questions. So in totality if you just check it, so over here you have to write down 2 words, no change for isothermal. For adiabatic, simply dq is 0, so du is equal to minus dw. This implies that du is not 0. Fine. full 1 mark. Now come for second question. This is question number 2, and it is again for 1 mark. Can two isothermal curves intersect each other? Okay, it's a technical question, and if you are comfortable with your concepts, you will say it's a very easy question. Now, two isotherms cannot cut each other. Why? Let's take a look. Two isotherms will not cut each other. Why? Because then at two temperatures there will be same value of P and V, which is not possible. Because then at two temperatures, same value of volume and pressure. So it is not possible that for two different temperatures, pressure and volume is same. That's why two isotherms will not cut each other. Fine, it's up to you to write down the answer, and simply mention no will not cut, else two values of P and V, something like that. Fine, total answer I provided. Now students, this is question number 3, and in this question number 3 instruction is 2 marks. Fine, so here you have to write down 2 lines. Simple. What is the question? Ice at 0 degree centigrade is converted into steam at 100 degree centigrade. Okay, this is ice block. I started providing heat energy. So what will happen? Ultimately conversion into vapor, but in between so many things will take place. Okay, keep it in mind. State the isothermal changes in this entire process. Now this question, very specifically I devoted good amount of time, and I draw a diagram, a graph, with the help of which I explained this entire scenario. The question I simply picked in between that particular explanation. What is the question? Take a look over here. Forget about the question. This is a ice block. When I will start providing the heat energy to this ice block, then what will happen? This ice block will start melting, and it will be converted water at 0 degree centigrade. Minimum, what we can assume, that ice is at 0 degree centigrade. So 0 degree centigrade ice converted to 0 degree centigrade water. Fine. This is a change, Q is equal to ML type of equation you have to apply, and during this phase change process, no change in temperature. After that, this 100 degree centigrade water will start getting, 0 degree centigrade water will start getting the heat energy, will start increasing its temperature. At 100 degree centigrade, this boiling process will start, vaporization will start. So here again, when the phase change water into gas, then no change in temperature. So there are two isothermal changes. Fine. Thermal changes. Number 1. 0 degree centigrade ice to 0 degree centigrade water. Fine. Second is 100 degree centigrade water to 100 degree centigrade vapor. Okay? So this is the scenario. Now, this much is the complete answer for this 2 marks question. Simply write down this much. Move on to the next question. Nobody can deduct any mark. 1, 1. That's it. Wherever possible, please save your time so that you can devote that time for some long questions. Fine. Sometimes in any calculation, okay, you need some time. So try to save your time. Then comes question number 4. And this question is again for 2 marks. Don't forget it. If an electric fan be switched on in a closed room, will the air of the room be cooled? Actually, this question is a logic based question. Only a student who studied the topic very well, he or she can answer this. Otherwise, in 2 marks, you will keep on writing, meaningless. If not, why do we feel cold? Now forget about the question. Let's say there is a ceiling fan arranged over here, although it is stopped and chilling factor is working, like AC is working. When I switch on the ceiling fan, it will start rotating. Fine. So question is, in a closed room, will the air of the room be cooled? Answer is, air will not be cooled. Rather, it will be heated. Fine. Why? The air masses will hit the blades of the fan and then they will thrown out. They will strike to each other. More momentum transfer. Theoretically, more energy changes. So cooling will not take place first. So first answer is no. Now, if not, why do we feel cold? I mean, why we feel not cold, but why we feel comfortable? Let's say you are coming in a room from outside, sweating and all like that. Moment you switch on the fan, you feel slightly comfortable. Why? It is because, first answer is this. Second part answer is, why we feel cold? Due to increased vaporization, we feel comfortable. Okay? So this is the answer of this question. Then comes question number 5, and this question instruction is 3 marks. Fine. Now in 3 marks, and deliberately I place these type of theoretical questions, because solving a numerical is really easy, and scoring complete full marks in a numerical is also simple. But about these type of theoretical questions, solving and scoring full marks is really difficult. Reason is simple. With the help of this question, I will tell you the reason. Your board, CBSE board, provides instruction set to the examiner or paper evaluator. If in this particular question, these points are mentioned, provide full marks. If this is missing, cut half marks, something like that. So we will try to reach near to that ideal situation. Fine. Now, the question is, briefly, the concept of internal energy. Now, you can write down so many things, like 2-3 pages about internal energy, but that is not required. You have to confine your discussion, internal energy concept, obviously, in terms of temperature variation and for ideal gases. Although, whatever you will discuss about the ideal gas, it will be fully applicable onto the real gases up to some extent also. And actually, the idea of ideal gas in terms of this real gases, van der Waals real gases, is for very high temperature and very low pressure, almost all real gases behaves as ideal gas. Fine. So let's start the discussion of this internal energy. Students, in class 11th itself, in this class, while we were discussing work per energy chapter in mechanics, we were discussed kinetic energy, potential energy, even in rotational motion we explained rotational energy, gravitational potential energy, something like that. Then what is the internal energy? Is it like that in this room the particles of the gases are moving randomly because of the temperature difference? Fine. So they are in a position to possess some amount of momentum, and then because of the collision they are transferring the energy also. So for a gas you can say internal energy is a function of temperature, and because of the motion of the molecules of the gas, random motion, they possesses some velocity, and because of that reason we can impart some kinetic energy to them, and that clubbing of entire kinetic energy of all the gas molecules is defined as the internal energy. Internal energy, you can confine something like that on the basis of which the gas can perform some work. Say for example, you have a big balloon, and take a needle, pick the needle in the balloon, balloon will blast, it will create a sound. It is adiabatic expansion. The gas is expanding at the cost of its own internal energy. So cooling will take place. Even a tire of a truck, if burst suddenly, then loud thud and some amount of water is present in and around that. From where it is coming? Cooling process. So water molecules present in the surrounding gaseous system, they will cool down, settle down as a liquid. Once again, internal energy of the molecules of the gas is because of the temperature difference with the surrounding random motion, or RMS velocity of the gas molecules is responsible for some momentum and energy of the gas molecules. Fine. So in point wise form, I will just tell you one or two things. That is, internal energy energy of a gas given by, given by U, delta U change, internal energy of a gas given by U is a function of temperature. Fine, is a function of temperature. Root mean square velocity RMS velocity is also associated. Okay. Few more points I would like to mention over here. Due to temperature difference, due to temperature difference, the random motion of molecules gets affected. Fine. So this is also something which is associated with the internal energy. All in all, you can say the total energy possessed by the molecules of the gaseous system is defined as the internal energy of that particular gas system. Fine. So this concept is not a very difficult, anyway it is not difficult, but you should ensure from your side that yes, you are providing, you are mentioning, you are writing important aspects only. It's not like that the entire story, keep on mentioning, nothing like that. You simply can't say for 3 marks question, I mentioned 5 pages and but I received 1 mark. Should not be like that. Fine. Then comes second law of thermodynamics. Now students, this is again in 3 marks and here nothing is applicable from your side or my side. A statement by various scientists is given. You have to simply write down that definition. Fine. Never ever do that thing. What is machine? Machine is anything that reduces the efforts of the human beings. If you want to score marks, you have to write down whatever mentioned in your books, because you don't know more than the books. That's it. Fine. So with this suggestion, I would like to mention 2-3 names over here. For example, in this second law of thermodynamics, if you want to write down, mention as it is given, so you have choice. Either you can mention Kelvin, it's the name of the scientist, Kelvin Planck statement. You can write down this. And please, in this statement, no addition or subtraction from your side, because you are not Kelvin or Planck. Either you write down this, or another name that I would like to mention is Clausius statement. Either you can write down. How you should write down? I'm going to write down one statement. It's your choice. You love it, you remember it or not, or you want to read something from your other materials or books. Fine. So what is the statement? One statement I'm writing. That is, it is impossible. It is impossible to construct, it is impossible to construct, now it is associated with heat engine or machine. It is impossible to construct a heat engine, which would absorb heat from reservoir and convert 100% of absorbed heat as useful work. So just read this statement. In totality, the statement is saying simply one thing. It is not possible for you to convert any heat amount into 100% work. Impossible. Some amount of heat energy or resource, you have to waste it. Say for example, you cannot create a heat engine in which you can put petrol 1 liter and you will be, no exhaust, no fumes, nothing like that. 100% conversion, impossible. Fine. So this second law is basically incorporating all those practical issues faced by the first law, because first law simply says what? That is conservation of energy. Now 7-8-4 marks explain what is meant by isothermal operations. Just some time back, 2-3 questions back, I explained isothermal operations. So you can simply say any operations in which temperature remains constant, that is isothermal. So that 3-4 lines you can write down. Give some examples. I just mentioned, try to recall, conversion of ice into water, conversion of 100 degree wala water into 100 degree wali vapor, something like that. So you have to just write down like this. Now this question I place so that you can get the understanding. If the same type of question is asked in 2 marks, what should be your approach? If the same type of question is asked in 4 marks, what should be your approach? So you have to elaborate yourself. Fine. Now let's come on to question number 8. Discuss briefly any 3 applications of first law of thermodynamics. Fine. Let me allow to mention, you can explain first, because it is in 4 marks. So first mention first law, dq is equal to du plus dw. Then boiling, melting, conversion into water into vapor, conversion of ice into water, they all are examples of this application of first law of thermodynamics. Because what first law is saying? First law is simply saying dq is equal to du plus dw. That's it. And to write down this answer very properly, you have to take a look of my video. I think it was video number 3 or 4, fine, where I explained all these aspects. So if you are regularly watching our videos, no question is beyond that. Okay. Now then comes question number 9 to 10. It is a numerical problem. I hope now you will find yourself in a comfortable position. A quantity of air at 27 degree centigrade and atmospheric pressure, that is 1 P, suddenly compressed to half its original volume. Suddenly means it is adiabatic process. Adiabatic process means P1 V1 to the power gamma is equal to P2 V2 to the power gamma, or T1 V1 to the power gamma minus 1 is equal to T2 V2 gamma minus 1. Use the formula, put the values, solve it. If I will solve it over here on the board, it is anyway not going to be help you. Fine. Reason is simple. Unless and until you will not solve the numericals by yourself, you will not able to solve them in the examination hall also. Question is simple. Formula I mentioned. Try from your side. If you are interested for the answer, I can mention that, but that is of no use unless and until you are not comfortable with the values. Now one thing that will definitely create a problem for you: what is the value of gamma? Air is considered as diatomic, and in my lectures I mentioned the value of diatomic, polyatomic, monoatomic, linear polyatomic, non-linear, every values I mentioned. Fine. Then comes question number 10. A diatomic gas does 200 joule of work when it is expanded isobarically. Isobaric means dq is equal to du plus dw. Dw is given, and also you have PV is equal to mu RT. From here I can write down PdV. This relation I very properly discussed in my videos twice, not once but twice. PdV plus VdP is equal to mu RdT. Isobarically means, so PdV is equal to mu RdT. And what is the value of PdV? PdV itself is given 200 joule, because dW is what? PdV. Fine. Find the heat given to the gas in this process. DQ you have to find out. So these questions are anyway not difficult questions. You just have to take a look of our videos regularly and then you will find yourself in a very comfortable position. So with this, students, I would like to say that we should stop over here. And last two questions, please work out from your side and take the look of our videos regularly. With this positive suggestion, I would like to say thanks to all of you for watching this video. Take care of yourself. Have a nice time.